Dr. Art Hister has spent many minutes sitting across from me dispensing sage medical advice. Laced with a little bit of his trademark humor, we ask him to return to Studio 4 to celebrate our fun times as things are changing here at Shaw TV. And it is my pleasure to welcome Dr. Art back to Studio 4 to tell us more.
See the grin on my face? It is so nice to be back.
Well,
here.
So nice to see you.
Yeah,
we've been a good dog and pony show for many years.
We certainly did. It's been a long time since I've been here, but I want you to know I got my, I don't wear a jacket ever on TV, and I got this out because I remember you and Leslie talked me into buying a jacket.
Yes,
to be
it was my then producer.
That's right, who said I will look bigger and taller with a jacket.
And you look more doctor-like.
Yeah, I do. I'm much more authoritative.
You did run that clinic. I know we've talked about it before, that Pine Tree Clinic, and I think you were the doctor in sandals and...
I was. I had a
Hawaiian
ponytail.
Shirts or
yeah, well, no, t-shirts and cutoffs. Mm-hmm. It was a long time ago, Fanny. Mm-hmm. We all go through changes, right?
Of course.
I had the ugliest ponytail in the history of humanity. Could you believe me and a ponytail?
No, but as you age, you can bring a ponytail back.
Apparently, especially if you work in L.A. But I know me. This is me now.
Mm-hmm. You can do whatever you want.
I know. Yeah. It takes a while to realize that.
Do you miss the daily practice at all?
Yeah, you know what I miss? And this is true, really quite seriously, I really miss my patients. I had the loveliest practice. It was a different era. We sort of grew up together, right? We were never going to grow old. We were never going to die. We were the golden generation, mm-hmm. you know, the 60s, 70s, hippie, trippy kind of people. And they were absolutely the best people to be a part of, right? And I was an important part of that community. Mm-hmm. I miss them like crazy. The other thing you miss at home, if you do what I do now, which is, you know, you prepare stories and you go on and you're on TV for a couple of minutes, I miss the interchange with people that I used to have. I have nobody to talk to. Mm. So when Phyllis comes home, I grab her and I just tell her all the boring things that happened to me that day,
right.
Which was nothing.
Phyllis is your wife, in case people don't
That's
know.
Right, yeah.
She usually calls you when you're on the show.
That's right. You made me shut off my cell phone so I didn't get a call
because
from her.
That has rung before.
Oh, several times. Mm-hmm. I miss that. I don't miss the work at all. The mm-hmm. work, and I don't miss the stress, and I don't miss the downsides of having to tell people bad news. And, you know, the older you get, the older your practice gets, the more of that there would have been. So I'm not sorry I made the career change. I wish there was a way of combining the two.
I did a show yesterday with Alan Castles. He's a medical researcher who wrote Seeking Sickness, mm-hmm. and we talked at length about medical imaging mm-hmm. and all these ads that say, get a scan, it will save mm-hmm. your life. He says, not so.
No, he's right.
Like the scans can be a bit dangerous, and if you don't feel badly,
there's absolutely no evidence that they make any difference in terms of what you're going to expect. And I know they advertise them like crazy. I get a ton mm-hmm. of emails from people asking if they should get them. There is no study that has ever shown that if you get them, you're going to do better than if you don't get them. And I would argue that there's a real downside to it, as I'm sure Alan did. I wouldn't worry that much about the radiation, although that can add up depending upon the kind of scans you get. What I'd worry much more is that they often find things that don't matter.
That's what he said.
Incidentalomas, they're called in medicine. And what happens when you find something that you're not sure about? Well, our tendency is to want to do something about it. And when you do something mm-hmm. in this business, you run into complications and side effects
of
the treatment. Mm. So,
he said be responsible, but mm-hmm. don't get a test for everything. And some of the tests aren't accurate. And ask the questions.
Absolutely.
Ask the questions. Why do I need this? Do I really need this? Is there an alternative? And as the big pharmas drive, medicine.
I don't just blame corporations for this. It's also our tendency. We want that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. I think the consumer gets off far too easy sometimes on these things. People want easy answers. So you want to know that if you get one test, you can know forever. Yeah, I'm going to live to exactly this age, and here's what I should do.
Well, let's hope we live to at least 104.
Both of us.
And we are healthy and
That's
happy.
Right. Or
and
all of us, not just
vital.
Both of us.
Let's all of us
all
live
of us
to 104.
Live to that,
what we're going to do because they're running out of cheap oil, I don't know, will be colder.
Yeah, well, we'll manage.
But there you go. But we were joking earlier before you got here, and we said, Rashad Ali, my producer, and I said, Well, we should tell Dr. Hister, we know how to live happier, healthier lives. You sit down a lot.
Yeah.
You smoke, you drink.
Yeah, oh, there you go. That's right.
You watch a lot of television.
And you know what? I was just reviewing a study today.
You're really negative.
Yeah, well, there you go. I was reviewing a study today for an article I'm writing. And if you do that and you're a middle-aged male, you cut your life expectancy by 15 years if you combine all those things.
So, really?
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
No,
being
exactly.
Quite serious. Yeah. Again, it's easier to do the bad things than it is to do the healthy things. So a lot of us have unhealthy.
And you are a proponent of everything in moderation. I know
Absolutely.
That. You talk constantly about balance.
Yes.
And if your blood pressure is 2 points up, don't stress.
That's right. Well, you know, what are you going to do? Okay, this morning, for example, a study that is going to get a lot of attention.
I know what you're going to say, calcium.
Calcium supplements, right? And you know what? How many women over the age of 50 are taking them? They're all going to freak out. Well, you know what? If you actually look at the study, which did find a higher rate of heart attacks in calcium supplement users, there are a lot of weaknesses in the study. And remember that. And freaking out isn't going to help anybody, right? So if you're taking them and you think it's helping prevent osteoporosis, you wait, you sit down. Don't panic. You weigh the risks and the benefits. Right?
Yes.
See, I'm getting older, Fanny. Yeah. Those words don't come as easily.
You might need ginkgo biloba.
Yeah, well, that doesn't work. I wish it did. And
it doesn't
work. I had a ton of blueberries this morning, and those do work. So
okay.
You can imagine what I'd be like without the blueberries. Mm-hmm. Anyway, you weigh the risks and the benefits, and then you decide for yourself how that balances.
And if you get osteoporosis, and they say take Fosamax, you say what are the side effects? It's
precisely. And you know what? If we had to come up with one really good lesson for people, that would be it. Use your common sense and ask a lot of questions. And don't let anybody make up your mind for you. You don't walk into a doctor's office and say, hey, give me a pill, doc, I want to live forever. You say, okay, what can I do? If you're going to give me something, what are the risks? You know, all that
right,
kind of
exactly.
stuff.
Right, exactly. Well, my poor doctor has to put up with me. You can imagine.
Well,
you know, and she
I know
says...
They've quit practice.
I don't blame her.
Yeah.
Because she says your thyroid's low and... You know, you can take a little bit of pig hormone or something. I go, no. I need to go to my yoga class and I'll do the fish pose.
Well.
That's supposed to up the thyroid. And when my hair falls out, maybe I will.
Yeah, well, your hair looks great. And you should know that 10% of postmenopausal women is probably a little bit higher these days.
And
actually,
that would be me.
Low thyroid. Well, I wasn't going to say that, but, you know,
well,
I'm postmenopausal as well. So we're in the same category. 10 to 15% have low thyroid levels. Depends on how low and how it's affecting you as to what you do. About it.
And I get that. And she said, if you get extremely tired and are dragging yourself
there
to work,
you
come and see me.
You don't
and
look
I say,
like a hypothyroid patient to me.
No,
so.
Not to her either, because usually they're plump and all of that. I say,
right.
I don't have any of the signs. But isn't there something about you're just born that way? Like my thyroid was probably low when I was 2.
Could have been. And there's a terrific genetic component to everything that happens to us. One of the nice things I've learned in this business, though, over the years, is that if your genes predestine you to have an unhappy outcome,
right.
And to put that in those kind of terms, to have certain risks, you can still trump those risks by doing the proper lifestyle things in most cases. A nice study out last week showed that people who have two parents who have high blood pressure, that predisposes them to a much higher risk of high blood pressure themselves, but they can trump that risk by doing enough exercise. So you're born with certain genetic tendencies, but don't let that govern your life. In some cases you can't help it,
and don't stress about it because that will take a shot
that
at your
never
health.
Helps That's...
try to relax,
exercise,
get active every day. You've always said that.
Are
you still climbing Kilimanjaro?
No, was
like
that the last thing? No, we didn't, but we do a lot of hiking. We still do. We do it slower than we used to. It's funny, you know, you wake up in the morning and you don't have as much energy as you used to. So you have to parcel things.
You walk, you garden, you move, you park your car 4 blocks away.
Yeah, I've always done that. I always park far away and walk to whatever venue I have. So you know, everybody does their own thing.
Obesity, we know diets don't work. Everybody's tried one and gained it back and gained it back. So fad diets aren't your thing. To eat? Dog?
Well, you just, you know, use your common sense. Moderation in everything and lots of fruits and veggies and lots of fish. You know, Mediterranean diet. You want one diet that works the best in studies.
Sure.
There are 23 countries that border the Mediterranean, okay? And they all eat somewhat differently. So there is no one Mediterranean diet. We're just there, by the way. We're in Turkey for 2 weeks. Yeah, it was terrific. Anyway, that's an aside. There is no one Mediterranean diet, but if you had to sort of factor out what they all share. A lot of fish, a lot of fruits and veggies, not that much meat, some grains. Okay. Balance, balance, balance. But remember, it's the Mediterranean. Wine is a fruit,
of course.
Right?
Wine yes, is it a is. Fruit. Wine's a fruit.
Coffee's a bean, right?
So, not a gallon of wine. That's a bad fruit.
Absolutely. In moderation, coffee. Well, that's the one thing that I really do push that a lot
coffee's
of
coffee's back.
Yes. What back? It never went away.
It didn't this go away for me, but remember, we had all those warnings about don't drink too much.
And if you cast your mind back, as I was pretty consistent in saying that I thought coffee was a health drink, and now the world's caught up to me.
You see, not with cream and sugar and double. This and double
that's
that,
right.
But
yeah.
A good strong coffee.
Absolutely, four
good
double
way
cappuccinos.
To go.
Well, you know, whatever.
And then, then you say, get enough sleep.
Mm-hmm. That's the hard one. I think that's the one that also becomes significantly more difficult as you age. I read an interesting thing that we all wake up every 90 minutes or so, or we sleep much less deeply every, you suppress it when you're younger, and as you get older, it becomes much harder to suppress that. So you wake up periodically at night. And of course, when you wake up.
And you stay awake.
Oh, of course.
I do the 2-hour shuffle
of course.
At 1 in the morning.
And you and every other postmenopausal woman out there.
What's that about?
Well, I've always said that the best time to have a women's book club meeting is at 2 in the
For
morning, because
sure.
you guys are all awake anyway.
So we're reading, we're writing in our journals.
Absolutely. What happens is we stress out, you start looking at the alarm clock and you think, I got to be up in 4 hours, and as soon as you start doing that, you're never going to go back to sleep. But it's funny, everybody I've talked to has that 1 to 2 hour period, right? You fall asleep again after 2 hours, right? Most of us do. I don't know why.
I don't either,
that.
But
I think you just get too tired of being stressed.
Maybe. Well, you spend the 2 hours in every position known to man
that's
and woman
it.
In the bed.
That's right.
Right? And you get the cold pillow, and then you go to both sides.
And you've worked out every problem you're going to work
absolutely.
Out. And this is the third time over.
Oh,
so
and
it's
terror?
Not working. Yeah.
How about that brain, that lizard brain
that's
kicking
right.
in?
I
a
know.
Lot of fear at 2 in the morning.
So just realize it's not abnormal. So many other people are going through it. You should try and get enough sleep. Enough sleep, there's no set amount of hours that you need. I know people love that. It's really how tired you are the next day. If you're tired the next day, you didn't get enough sleep.
Sure, have a little nappy.
Mm-hmm,
but I don't need much sleep. And this is not about me. Never have.
No.
Always
no.
been,
a lot of people
you know, a 5 to 6, 8 hour girl.
Margaret
max.
Thatcher was supposed to apparently only sleep 4 hours a day.
Really? Do you think we're any smarter?
For doing that? Yeah. Well, you're smart
I
enough.
I don't know.
Whatever you're doing is working.
I don't know if it's linked to intelligence, the fact
so.
You don't sleep much.
No.
No, but Einstein didn't sleep much, so maybe.
There you go.
So Fraser Valley Retirement Planning and Healthy Living Show, you'll be there?
I'll be there on Saturday. It runs from Friday to Sunday.
Okay.
A lot of booths, a lot of interesting things.
Great.
On the keynote.
At Chilliwack Heritage Park.
Yeah, and I'm the keynote on Saturday, noon and 2.
What about the 27th?
No,
that's
I'm not
a fib?
There. That no, it's on the 27th because it runs Friday to Sunday, but I'm not there. I'll be
just
there
on
Saturday.
The 25th.
Yeah,
okay.
On the 26th.
Just getting it straight so we don't have a riot.
Yeah, on the 26th. So everybody in the Fraser Valley, love to see you.
Well, thanks for doing this.
Oh, Fanny, it was such a joy.
Yeah, it
always
great.
Is.
We had a lot of fun in Studio 4.
Yeah.